All right, so the decline in the commodity prices, especially for food and fuel, has helped the country register the lowest inflation rate in the last 15 months. So earlier this week, again, a bit of statistics did indicate that there was a drop from about 4.9. That's in the last 12 months. Now it's 3.9, the headline inflation for the country. I think all this should be as a result of the really good work that the central bank is doing in trying to curb the inflation. And also we've seen over the years, or over the recent months, as the central bank lending rate has been dropping steadily. We can only hope that this remains constant or drops constantly, because the lower it is, then the better for us that are spending money every day, mostly on fuel, food, charcoal, or any other thing that comes in there. If you have a lot of money and you're spending it but not getting value for it because the inflation is high, then you are probably thinking, so what am I doing with all this money? You don't need to carry a sack to buy a loaf of bread. Welcome to the Business Show.
I decided to venture into the shoes because people buy shoes, people love shoes, and it's one way that I could incorporate my passion, which is designing using an African print, normally commonly known as a kitenge, that I can give it to people and they not only look at them as kitenge for clothes, because in Africa most people think that kitenge is only to be worn as clothes. So I wanted to give people a variety of ways of being able to use a kitenge, not only in clothes. So that's where I specialized in African, or what we call Ankara shoes. We call them Ankara shoes, yes.
All right, so let's get the show started this week. And there's been so much in the world of business, but we'll start with the recent visit of the president and a delegation of ministers and private sector players, plus other dignitaries to Serbia, where different business deals, bilateral contracts, or deals were cut, literally, or signed, you should be saying. This has raised a lot of concern for on the social media, because people are asking, okay, so where are the players, where are the SMEs, where are the actual farmers of these products that are going to be, you know, exported to these hubs? This week on Views from the Top, the Business Show has been speaking to Jonel Gembe, who is the executive director of the Federation of Small and Medium Enterprises in the country. And we've been trying to weigh in on what this means for the common farmer or the common businessman, and just how realistic the hub will be in trying to connect the different farmers or exporters that are carrying out the exportation of produce to Serbia, or the business hub particularly that is set in the country. The interesting conversation with Jonah Weber is there is some stuff that we have to do in terms of packaging and also ensuring that our farmers or exporters are trained on the basics of what they need to do to benefit from this opportunity. This is Views from the Top.
Your general assessment of the president's visit to Serbia and the different bilateral agreements that were signed, what does that mean to the economy generally?
I think the president's visit to Serbia is one to be applauded. Uganda needs to explore new markets, and I think Serbia is a very important partner that can give us a stepping stone into the larger EU market. Of course, Serbia is not a member of the EU yet, but we believe that with time they will join, but most importantly, the experience gained from serving the Serbian market can help us to penetrate neighboring countries and ultimately the EU market. That said, Serbia is a small country and our expectations shouldn't be very high. Of course, it's good that these agreements are signed, but the expectations shouldn't be very high, because it's a small country and it's not part of the EU, so those are the limitations. But on the positive side, every market that we penetrate is a plus for us, and we should therefore applaud government for this initiative.
Okay, so we know the fact that there are several markets, and now you say this is a new market which we should really, you know, utilize.
Yes.
How do we position ourselves to ensure that what we supply maybe is better than what could come from other countries into Serbia?
So I think the key change now is we've not just tried to penetrate as very many small actors, but we've set up this trade hub. So if this approach continues, it means that individual producers don't have to struggle for supermarket shelf within Serbia, but rather can use this trade hub as an entry point into the wider Serbian market. So if we continue with this approach, I think it will be very positive. That would also be the case ultimately for the EU, for the US market, for the African market. If we take this trade hub approach, I think it will be very beneficial for our export ambitions.
So the hub that has been set up, you know, is more like an arriving point or arrival point for the different products going into Serbia, which could be a good thing. But from your reading, do you think the products that were showcased really inform what Uganda has as a country, and is that what we should be pushing out?
Definitely, Uganda has more products. I don't think we could have displayed the wide variety of the Ugandan products in just one event or just one engagement. But the important thing is that the hub has been set up, and the hub is there permanently. So if it's there permanently, it means there will be more opportunities for other producers to take advantage of that market. But the goods that are stocked will evolve based on the needs of the consumers in that market. And I think the operators of the hub should be able to respond to the needs and the demand in order to ensure that they operate sustainably. Okay? But I would say that overall, that was a good start. Let's see how it evolves. We'll learn some lessons, and then we can see how to expand into other markets.
So we know how these, you know, bilateral agreements always work. Sometimes it looks like a high-end kind of thing.
Yes.
So now that these things have been signed, moving on, how does the government then localize for people that then fall under, let's say, the association that you head? Then benefit from these opportunities?
No. All the SME, any SME that meets the quality and other requirements, in principle, should be able to access that trade hub. So I don't think there are any restrictions whatsoever. I'm not familiar with the guidelines, but my sense is that any producer that has qualifying product should be able to access the hub. And SMEs, therefore, this means that an SME does not need to invest in distribution networks in Serbia, for instance. Mm-hmm. Once you get your products to the hub, they'll sell, and then you'll get your proceeds, things like this. So it helps you on issues around payment infrastructure, it helps you on issues around storage, it helps you on issues of logistics. So I think the trade hub approach is the way to go.
So I know for a fact that there's several things that we need to do. I know you say you're not very conversant with the what needs to be done for the different businesses to benefit. But generally, even for those that maybe already understand this, are there things you think should be done? Let's say training of the different business people to understand how these things work, you know?
There's definitely need for preparatory work around making businesses ready to tap into these markets. There's also need for support in the areas of financing to ensure that businesses are able to have the necessary resources to access this market. So there's a lot of supply side work that ought to go into making sure that our businesses are producing the right products in the right quantities and in the right that meet the right quality, the required quality. Yes, so that work therefore needs to be done going forward.
Okay.
Not just for the Serbian market, but generally speaking.
All right, Joe, let's move the talk away from the Serbian, you know, visit and what was agreed. Let's just maybe have a conversation around, we are into a new financial year. What do you want to tell us about the federation that you had in terms of what you were able to score high on in helping the different members that fall under you in the last financial year, and what are some of the things you're looking up to now in this financial year?
The federation has scored high on supporting businesses through our various programs, whether supporting women entrepreneurs, whether supporting the digital inclusion of businesses, and whether pushing It's the policy agenda that supports a conducive environment for MSMEs. So I would say that we've done quite well in the circumstances. You can see that there's a bit of stability in the macro kind of context. Inflation is moderating now. It's come down to about 3.8-3.9%, thanks to the efforts of the central bank, the Ministry of Finance, among others. We are also seeing a lot of support programs that seek to support SMEs, and we have been working with government agencies to ensure that there is greater uptake of these. So I would say that the Federation has been right at the center of where it's supposed to be in supporting the growth of MSMEs.
What areas are you looking at in this financial year?
In this financial year, we shall continue with supporting SMEs in those areas. In the area of advocacy, business human services, market access, digital transformation, among others. So these are the broad priorities that we have over the next 4 years. So we shall remain consistent and true to those.
Okay. There was a talk about, I think this is something that we've, you know, had a conversation around for some time. Mm-hmm. And I think it's something you're following up on, how your members can benefit from the funds that we put, the billions that we put to help them. Is there any new development from your side?
No, I think there are various funds, not just the UDB ones. There's the Small Business Recovery Fund,
Recovery Fund,
I think there's a bit of greater uptake. We don't get regular reports, which is a pity, but I think we should, to see what's working, what's not working, how we can rectify some of these issues. But I think we are starting to see some kind of increase in uptake.
What would be your message to your members?
I think for SMEs in general, we would continue to urge them to do their work, to grow their businesses, because in that way, they'll create jobs for young people, contribute to our resource base, and help this economy to grow. So we would want to encourage them to do what they do, with a seriousness that it deserves.
Well, I guess it's a good stuff there, and we know that Serbia is not yet under the EU, but creating new markets for a country like ours is thumbs up, I should be saying, yeah? Because look, if we have all these other SADC, ECOWAS, and the East African Community region, we need to see just how more we can exploit to have all these things that we produce in this country exported. I tell you what, you could sit back and say, but what is there to export? But until you move around this country, will you realize that there's so much that goes into West. Go to these different markets and see the products or the produce that comes out from these gardens. You go up country, for instance, a sack of Irish goes for about 70,000 shillings. That's more like nothing. So at the end of the day, you're asking yourself, what does the farmer benefit? But imagine if the same Irish was packaged or cleaned, packaged, and shipped to Serbia, how much a farmer would be reaping. So we can hope that such conversations continue. And like I said, a thumbs up to the government and the delegation that was in Serbia. We await to see how this is implemented to benefit the last man or the last farmer that is trying so hard to bring stuff on the market. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Time now for a quick break on the program. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Our socials are right below your screen. Tell us what you think or where you're watching from, or better still, how your business is faring. We'll be more than glad to hear from you. I'll see you shortly. Stay with us.